Too bad, you fool. You missed by inches. As long as I remain conscious, you cannot stop the wall from bursting. Now watch, and witness your friends being blown to bits. Hello and welcome to One Piece 101, the series that breaks down everyone and everything in the One Piece world. Today, we'll be taking a look at the very short-tempered member of the Donquixote Pirates, Gladius. Gladius is a relatively mysterious man, often clad in a long black coat with golden ornate detailing. As mentioned in the introduction, he is an officer of the Donquixote Pirates, led by former Warlord of the Sea, Donquixote Doflamingo. To be quite specific, Gladius is a member of the Pika Division within the crew, which specializes in undertaking assault missions. As with most officers, Gladius is extraordinarily loyal to his captain. In fact, when Gladius was first introduced into the series, his immediate action consisted of shooting another of his fellow officers, who was assaulting Doflamingo at the time. And in fact, Gladius has been shown performing similar actions on two other occasions, during the betrayal of both Viola and Corazon. Despite those two figures also being trusted officer agents, Gladius was exceptionally quick to act in both instances, proving his incredibly solid loyalty to Doflamingo, but also quite clearly displaying his anger management issues. Although it must be said that his short temper works quite well in conjunction with his devil fruit, which is the Pamu Pamu no Mi. This fruit is a paramecia type that gives the user the ability to generate explosions within inorganic objects, as well as within the user's own body. And it should be noted that even after exploding a portion of your own body, the user remains unharmed, making this quite a devastating fruit actually if used properly. For example, one of Gladius's ultimate attacks involves him inflating his entire body, eventually causing a massive explosion, but also resulting in a release of thousands of tiny needles coated in poison. And this is because Gladius just so happens to coat his hair in poison, as you do. But Gladius's power works particularly well in synergy with the ability of Sugar, another Donquixote officer. She is able to turn living beings into toys, thus making them inorganic matter and susceptible to being exploded and killed rather easily by Gladius. But it must be said that Gladius is also quite a powerful fighter without the use of his devil fruit. He has been shown taking one of Luffy's Gear 2nd attacks and pretty much just shrugging it off, making him exceptionally durable, and he was able to capture several members of the Tontada tribe, proving that he possesses highly impressive agility as well. As for his history, it's unknown exactly when Gladius joined the Donquixote Pirates, but he was already an officer by the time that Trafalgar Law originally joined. And although Gladius was only 17 at the time, he appears to have had a decent knowledge of the world, as he was able to explain the history of the country of Flavance to Baby 5. And I say decent knowledge of the world, but I'm really just comparing Gladius to any other character we've known in their late teens, such as Luffy, Zoro, and Usopp, who know nothing. At this point in time, Gladius was also highly skilled in the art of gunnery, and was even instructed by Doflamingo to teach the practice to Law. After being informed of Corazon's treachery, Gladius accompanied Doflamingo to Minion Island, and participated in beating Corazon quite viciously as a result of his betrayal. Gladius was also present for the takeover of Dressrosa, and he took up residence there once Doflamingo had installed himself as the country's king. And hey, that may as well take us to modern day, when the Straw Hat Pirates infiltrated Dressrosa along with Trafalgar Law, who was plotting revenge against Doflamingo. Gladius proved invaluable during the initial assault on the palace, managing to intercept Kuros in toy soldier form, as well as the Tontada tribe members. However, once the events of Dressrosa really kicked into gear, the Donquixote officers found themselves stretched quite thin around the island, and during this time, Gladius found himself in combat with Nico, Robin, Cavendish, and Bartolomeo. And Gladius did hold his own quite well for the most part, and did manage to severely injure Bartolomeo, a man who had a bounty of 150 million berries at the time. Although eventually Gladius would be overcome by a barrier-coated fist to the head, immediately knocking him unconscious, and leaving him out of action for the rest of the Dressrosa arc. And after the eventual defeat of Doflamingo, Gladius and most of his fellow officers were arrested by the Marine Forces, led by Admiral Fujitora. Some more fun facts about Gladius. In the anime, Gladius's mask and gloves are covered white, while in the manga they are black to match the rest of his attire. Despite his undying loyalty to Doflamingo, Gladius was unable to distinguish him from Kinemon, wearing a very poor Doflamingo disguise. Interestingly enough, Gladius means sword in Latin, referring in particular to a Roman short sword. And while this seems pretty out of place for Gladius, as he is primarily a gun patron, Oda has provided a childhood drawing of Gladius holding a Gladius. Gladius's devil fruit ability is very similar to Mr. Five's devil fruit, the Bomu Bomu no Mi. In both cases, the user can generate explosions through the use of their own body, however Mr. Five is unable to make objects other than himself explode. Despite the fairly brutal lifestyle Gladius leads, he appears to have a very low tolerance for any sort of morbid discussion, as he nearly threw up when Law was telling the story of how he hid in corpses. And finally, a truly useless fact. When a fan asked Oda if Gladius's penis can explode, Oda simply responded that it does, and it is terrifying. And that pretty much does it for Gladius. If you enjoyed this video, then feel free to like, favorite, or subscribe, and please do comment with who, what, or where you'd like to see featured in the next One Piece 101.